Hi everybody, this quick video will show you how to do graphs of sine and cosine in Desmos. So we'll do an example of each sine and cosine. For sine, we're going to look at f of x is 3 times the sine of 7x minus 2. To start off, I enter my function in Desmos. And maybe you're thinking, we've accomplished what we're supposed to do. But I want to make sure we can see two full periods, we want to look at the midline, we want to identify the max and the min, and we want to do something to make the tick marks look a little better. The first thing I know is that the midline is equal to y equals negative 2. This comes from the vertical transformation that's represented by the minus 2 in our function. I'm going to change that over to be a dashed line. We can see that the amplitude has changed, but it's a little hard to see exactly where it goes, so I'm going to go to the gear. And I'm going to change the y-axis to go by a step of 1. That way it'll add clear numbers to the graph, so now I can see it goes up to 1 and down to negative 5. I'm also going to remove the minor grid lines. Our graph also looked like it got smashed in. We can see there is a period change for the function. To determine the period, let's add a note to our graph. So add an item and add a note, and I'm going to write in that the period is equal to 2 pi, which is the normal period for sine, but I divide by 7, which is the coefficient of x. This shows me the horizontal distance needed for one full period of sine for this particular function. If we wanted to focus in and only see two periods of the graph, I can restrict the domain by saying we're going to start at 0, and then we will stop after two periods. Since each period is 2 pi over 7, we would have two periods at 4 pi over 7. So we'll put in less than or equal to 4 pi over 7. This allows us to see our graph in a little more detail. I could go back to the settings and say on the x-axis we want to start at 0. We want to stop at 4 pi over 7. And then you can see I put in a step of pi over 14. The pi over 14 comes from taking the period of 2 pi over 7 and dividing it by 4. 2 pi over 7 divided by 4 is 2 pi over 28. Which we can reduce to pi over 14. Now our tick marks correspond to the maximums and the minimums of the graph. We can also see all the points where the graph touches the midline. Let's do that one more time. This time we're going to do 2 times the cosine of 6x plus 1. I deleted all of my functions and I hit home to reset my graph. I'll start by typing in f of x is equal to 2 cosine of 6x and then plus 1. In this case, the plus 1 tells me I have a midline at y equals 1. Again, I'll go to the settings and I'll change that to a dashed line. Let's add a note that our period is equal to 2 pi over 6. This reduces to pi over 3. So just like the last one, I'm going to restrict my domain to show me two periods of the function. So I'm going to use a bracket. I'll start at 0, less than or equal to x, less than or equal to 2 pi over 3. Before I go to my settings and change my tick marks, I'm going to add another note, and I'm going to look at pi over 3 divided by 4. This will tell me where to put the tick marks on the graph. I can reduce this to pi over 12. So on the gear, I'm going to change my x-axis to go from 0 to 2 pi over 3, and I'll make the steps pi over 12. On the y-axis, you can see I go from negative 1 to positive 3. If that's too close, you can always move your mouse a little to get a better picture. Now with our tick marks and our midline, we can see the maximums, we can see the minimums, and we can see the points where the graph crosses the midline.